What's up, you guys? It's your girl Desmond Long, right back with another video. It's February, it's Valentine's Day month, so I had to put on my nice little pink for you guys. I'm so excited to be back with another video. I know you guys haven't seen me like in some days, but it's okay, you guys. I am back. Y'all already know what's about to happen, okay? Y'all already know, without even looking from the title of this video, y'all already know when I sit down on my bed, I got my nice little elephant here with me and I'm comfortable. That means we gonna talk. That means there's a discussion that we gotta talk about. Before we get started with this video, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on TikTok, follow me on Instagram, and we just gonna get right straight into this video. So today's video, you guys, we're gonna talk about my turnoffs that I have when it comes to men. Yeah, turnoffs. That's all we're talking about in this video. Y'all already know I wanna hear y'all opinions. I wanna know what y'all think. I wanna hear what you guys have to say. I wanna know. I always wanna know when I'm talking to you guys, I always wanna know about y'all opinions, okay? And y'all can always feel free to comment down whatever y'all wanna comment, whatever y'all feel like y'all should comment, whatever. I really don't care. The turnoff is something that you just don't. Because this happened or because you do this is the reason why I do not want to talk to you or wouldn't talk to you or wouldn't want to be with you. So it's like a ick. One turn off is somebody who stink. I can't be with somebody who stink. My dude, like, go take a shower. Because I can't, like, how can you be with somebody who stink? And I would just say that this is for everybody. I don't like people who stink, period. I don't like to be around people who stink. I don't like smelling any foul scents near my way. It could be shit on the floor, like, ew, I just can't smell things like that. It completely grosses me out. It's unattractive. I don't like, if I smell good, you need to smell good. And it ain't even about if I smell good, you need to smell good. You should already want to smell good. Everybody at this point in this life, and I'm going to say at this point, I'm pretty sure you want to smell good. Nobody want to be walking around smelling like fish, smelling like shit, smelling like dirty, sweaty socks. Like, come on, you don't want to smell like that. Like, I'm not about to be chilling with you and then you open your arms and I'm smelling mad foul scents underneath your arms. Or just when you walk. There's people who stink so bad. Just from when they're walking alone, you could just smell them. Like, that's how bad it could get, you guys. Like, it could get really, really, really bad. Or let's say we chilling on a bed and then you take off your socks and you stink. Like, your feet stinks really, really bad. Like, and I'm just supposed to just, like, lay up with you. No, we're not doing that. Like, you're not about to be in the bed or you're not about to be around me or not about to be anywhere in a date, whatever you want to call it, stink. Like, you're not about to be stinking. The same way how y'all wouldn't want y'all girls stinking any type of way. Please, y'all gotta make sure that y'all are clean, baby. Go take a shower, wash your clothes, wash your socks. Go find you some nice cologne that you could spray up when you're going out. Keep up with your hygiene. Like, if you can't keep up with your hygiene, then that is just, like, the biggest turn off at all. I don't want to be around nobody who stink. Do not come with me with no foul scent, no foul smell, because I'm gonna get turned off. And I'm not single, but if I was single and I was talking to somebody, just by that alone, I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're the best dressed. I don't care how much money you have. You could be the most respected man ever. You could be everything, whatever in the sun, whatever that floats, whatever. You could be anything that's like 10 out of 10, great personality, all that. If you stink, I will not speak to you. I'm not speaking to anybody who stink. That is a turn off. I like to smell good and you should want to smell good too. I'm not talking about you having a bad day. I'm not talking about, oh, you came from the gym. Obviously, you know, oh, you had like a workout day, or maybe you just having a bad day, whatever the case may be, whatever it is. That's fine because we're human. I understand that. But you cannot just be a stink person. You cannot be known for somebody who always smell or always carry that strange odor that's like, ew. Like, you can't do that. Like, no. Because if you stink, your room probably stink. I don't know what's going on in the room or what's going on with your body. But that's not okay. Another turnoff is someone who has a dirty room. You cannot have a dirty room, you guys. Okay? Do not have a dirty room. I don't want to be around anything that's just too much going on. Nobody want to be with somebody who doesn't care about where their belongings is, who doesn't care about like how their stuff looks. Like, I'm not saying that you have to be a neat freak. I'm not saying that you have to be this most perfect 100% well put organizer. If you are, you are, whatever. And I'm not saying that everything got to be sparkly clean. You got to be scrubbing your walls and repainting your walls and you gotta sweep every 5 minutes. No, nobody is saying that, okay? Nobody's saying that before y'all go ahead and overthink this situation, what I'm saying, and y'all probably gonna think, oh, this girl probably just want somebody to be 10 out of 10. My man is already 10 out of 10, okay?
Period.
But what I'm saying is, it's just like, nobody wanna be around that. I'm speaking for the girlies, okay? I'm speaking for the girlies. Y'all don't want that. Y'all don't want to be around. Y'all in a boy's house. You go in his room. You see everything all over the place. Everything is dusty all over the place. It's just too crowded. It's just too much things going on. There's like leftover food on the floor. There's like juice carts. Well, juice, whatever. Like you know how like when you drink juice in a cup and then you leave it on the floor? Or like you have like water bottles all over the floor. Crackers, let's say that you ate some chips and then you left the bag of chips on the floor, that's just pure dirtiness, okay? Nobody wants that. Nobody wants to see that. And like for guys, I'm pretty sure y'all wouldn't want to see that too, because you're gonna think that the girl is just like nasty. Like come on now. Do not have crackers or cookies or whatever that you eating all over the floor. They on your bed, they on the dresser. You guys, I know you're probably like, oh nah, nobody is doing that. Like, who does that? Y'all would be surprised. Like, there are actually people who go through these things, okay? There's actually people who act, who like don't care and will just leave it there. Yeah, don't be dirty. Don't be having all that trash and all that shit on the floor, because ain't nobody got time for that. And ain't nobody about to be clean up after you, and ain't nobody about to be coaching you and preaching to you how you got to walk around with a clean room. I'm not your mom. You know, we're not doing that. You don't have to do that. No, you don't have to do that, okay? That person at this grown-ass age, majority of us is in our 20s, whatever. Yeah, get it together, because ain't nobody dealing with all that, and nobody want to deal with all that, and nobody want to see with all that. Next thing I would say is somebody who can't speak. And when I mean by somebody who can't speak, like, you could tell from this person is from the hood. Like, you could just tell this person is from the hood. He is ghetto. His whole family is ghetto. Like, yeah, I'm not saying that y'all have to have perfect class and y'all have to speak to me with 10 different new vocabulary words I probably even never heard of. That's not what I'm saying. Because people like to overthink the situation. Relax. That's not what I'm saying. But people, you'll be surprised. Like, some guys can't even speak for real. They can't speak. Like, what are you even saying? Like, you know when a person is just too hood?
That's how true it is.
Sometimes a person just be too hood for, like, you just too hood. Like, what are you even saying? You know them strong accents? Oh my god, I probably have to pull up something for y'all to even understand what I'm saying. But like, some people just can't speak. Like, what are you even saying? Like, did you even go to school? Like, come on now. I'm about to show y'all something. I can't even find it, you guys. I can't even find it. But those who don't know what I'm talking about, I can't. Like, I'm over here trying to find a TikTok video or something to probably even show y'all what I'm talking about. But I can't find it. And people who can't talk in accents is just like two different things. So I'm not talking about like somebody who have an accent. I'm talking about people who just can't, like, what are you even saying? Like, please speak English. Like, stop using all these different types of like slang talk and these different little abbreviations. That's just like, no, like, speak proper, please. Like, speak English so people can understand what you're saying. Like, you'll be surprised, people really just can't speak for real. Like, they just sound dumb as like what they're saying. And I don't I would say somebody who has is another turn off is somebody who have no goals. Somebody who's not thinking bigger. Someone who doesn't have any dreams. There are many people out there in the world who, like, yeah, you know, I have a job, and yeah, you know, that's about it. And yeah, no, that's a turn off. Think bigger. You want to be around your partner or whoever you're speaking to with someone who is thinking outside the box, someone who has a dream, someone who has goals, someone who has plans to get to accomplish their goals, someone who sees themselves on a whole different and bigger level compared to how they are now, someone who has motive, good intention, someone who is like, yeah, this is what I want, and I'm gonna try my best to make sure I get there. This is what I also want to do. This is something that I also want to get into. This is something that I also want to learn. You know what I'm saying? Like, people, I feel like men who think like that, and you know, who just show like, yo, like, you really not like in a box, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're thinking abroad. Like, you thinking big, and that's really, really good, because that's something that you want to have somebody who you want to have around that could also motivate you and influence you to do, you know, like a good thing. Y'all know the saying of where people be like, you kind of feed off your partner sometimes. Like, you want to be with somebody who thinks like that, who, you know what I'm saying, who, like, it's just a good look for you, you know what I'm saying, and for you to, like, really mean it and actually attempt and make some effort to do it is just, like, 10 out of 10. A biggest turnoff to me is just somebody who just does not have that at all, who mind is just stick to one thing, who don't even have any type of dream or any type of future goals, you know what I'm saying? There's more to life than just, like, having a job and paying bills. Like, I refuse, and this is just me personally, I refuse to just feel like life is just all about working and paying bills. And in this world right now, it really do may seem like life is just about working to pay bills, because that's all we're doing. That's really majority of what's taking much more of our time. But if you don't make it be, if you don't like set your mind like, yeah, you know, I already know what I'm gonna do in my life, this is my job right now, and I'm just gonna work every day, might hang out here and there and just pay bills. Like, come on, are you serious? Where's the ambition? Where's the goals? Where's the dreams that you guys might have that you guys are probably scared to do? Like, those things that you're probably scared to do is something that you probably should do. Like, where's that business that you want to look into, that you want to start, you want to do something on the side? Like, you know what I mean? What's by 30 or what by 40? You have a goal. You want to buy a house. You know, like, you want to do this. You want to do that. You got to have more things that you want out of life. It can't just always and forever be about paying bills, just working and paying bills and just working and paying bills. It can't just be about that. You know, I'm not saying that you have to have this mindset where you want to be a millionaire or you want to be a billionaire, you got to be the most top this and that and third. And if that is, that's cool. Everybody's entitled to their own goals and dreams, but just think bigger. Always want more for yourself is what I'm saying. Like, you're more capable. You have the potential to do anything that you want to do more than you already are doing right now. So don't just stick your mind to just one thing when you don't even know that you have probably future talents and future other things that you could get yourself into and you don't even know that you're good at. You know what I mean? Because you just been sticking your mind to just one thing and you don't want to try and don't want to make an attempt to try different things and to do different things. Think bigger, think abroad, think wiser, all that. Don't just take your mind to just one thing, this is it, and no, baby, because I have goals and I have dreams and I'm thinking abroad and I'm thinking beyond my future, God willing, if I can live that long, and I have so many things that I want to do and so many things I want to try and so many things I want to learn. You got to be able to be open-minded and want to do the same thing too. Yes. Another turn off I would say is somebody who can't dress. You guys, I want to be able to go out with you. And if I look nice, you gotta look nice too. And I'm not telling you that you have to. Y'all be my, just chill. Because I don't want people thinking that I'm saying that you gotta have to have on a type of brand. Nope, we're not saying that. Because I know there's type of girls who probably like, nah, like, you gotta put on Gucci, you gotta have Louis Vuitton, you gotta have Miri's on, you know, before you even look my way. And that's other people's prerogative, and that's fine. Like, if y'all think that and if y'all want that, I don't care, that's y'all. But what I'm saying is that you gotta be able to know how to put two and two together and how to look nice. I don't want you looking any type of way. We not about to be at a spot and I look nice and you look crazy. We not doing that. Like, you just put on anything. You gotta have some type of sense of style is what I'm basically saying. You gotta have some type of sense of style. Like you put on together and you look good. Whether it's a streetwear, whether it's a whatever wear, whatever you wanna call it, I don't really know. Y'all gotta have some type of sense of style. Okay, and they gotta look good too. Putting on anything and thinking y'all anybody who would just put on anything, and you know, like, it's not really given. Like, you dress like, I don't really like that. Like, how somebody dress is very important. Their sense of style is very important. My sense of style is important to me. How I dress is important to me. What I wear is my style. I feel like, you know, like I love shopping. I like clothes. I like putting two and two together sometimes, especially if I'm doing a photo shoot. I like to look nice, and you gotta be able to want to look nice and like to dress nice too. Like, you have to want that too, okay? Please shop, buy yourself some nice stuff, figure out what's your style, get yourself some nice sneakers, you know, sweaters, jeans, whatever, put it on. You know, I'm not being specific about how much your attire has to be, because that's ridiculous, and I'm not about to tell somebody, no, you have to wear this a certain brand in order for you to speak to me. That's stupid. Honestly, that's just stupid, you guys. Don't be stupid, don't be dumb. Or I just named 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things for y'all. I'm trying to think to see if I have any more turnoffs that I'm missing out, because sometimes everything don't be coming up to head, and then when I finish the video, it's, oh, I should have said this, oh, I hate this, and everything start coming out. Another turn off, you guys, is someone who just likes to stay in the house all damn day. Baby, I like to go out. I like, and I mean by go out, like, I like to go out to different restaurants. I like to try different things. I like to, even if we're window shopping, I love that as well. Even if it's walks in the city, you know, stuff. I consider myself an outgoing person. Sometimes I could be a little bit more of an introvert, like, depending on how I'm feeling. Like, sometimes I like to chill in my bed and watch movies and, you know, be on TikTok, make content, you know, just be home. I love those moments, I'm not gonna lie. Right now I feel like I'm like in between of being like, I think I'm both an extrovert and an introvert. I think it depends on my mood and how I'm feeling. But yeah, but I would like someone to be like me. And that's why I'm so happy that my man is like, we kind of like the same person. Like, we both like to do things, like, anything, majority of the things that I like to do, he does, which I feel like is just perfect, because you like it, I like it, we doing it together, we having a good time. But, like, people who just don't like to go out, who won't try to plan anything, someone who won't try to say, like, hey, let's go this, let's do that. Like, as a man, you gotta have that. You know what I mean? Like, not all the time the girl is gonna, like, be the one to keep telling you, let's do this, let's do that, let me go think of a place we could do. Like, y'all have to do that too. Like, nobody wants to just sit here and just be with someone or find someone attractive who wouldn't even know where to take you, don't even know what's going on out there like that, because they're not paying attention, because they don't like to go out at all, because it's gonna seem as if, like, you're forcing the other person to do the things that you like to do, when deep inside they don't really like it. You know what I mean? So that's a turn off, because it's gonna make you feel uncomfortable, and it's just gonna, at the end of the day, it's just gonna make you feel like it's just better off being with someone who, not saying it's like 100% like you, but at least enjoy the same things that you like. So I feel like that's much better, because he's gonna want to do it, you're gonna want to do it, y'all always gonna be doing it, and y'all just gonna have a time together. So you just with somebody who don't care about that, who, like, would just rather be in a house all day, and he's comfortable, he loves it, he enjoys it, and this is not something that you want to do, because then you start to get bored, you start to get tired, you just start to just like, it's just not gonna mix well, unless you with someone who is willing to be open minded to, like, different things and new opportunities, and, you know, like, different stuff. Who's like, oh, okay, yeah, let's do it. You know, I don't really want to do it, but yeah, I want to do it. I'm gonna, you know, have a good time too. So that's another thing. But someone who, like, baby, you can't just sit here and just be this type of person and don't like to travel and don't like to try new foods with me and don't like to do this. No, you're gonna have to like to do all that, okay? You're gonna have to like to do all that. Yeah, I can't be the only one y'all can turn, and you over here acting like a grandpa. Like, come on. Come on now. Let me know what are y'all turn offs, any experiences that y'all had that y'all didn't like, that was like a completely no-no. Let me know. Comment down that below right now. No-no. Let me know. Comment down that below right now. And I will see you guys. I will see you guys in the next video. Not right now. And yeah, you guys, I'll see y'all in the next video.